हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम अश्विनी सौरभ मेहतरस फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ स्टैटिस्टिक्स RBNB कॉलेज श्रीरामपुर। टुडे वी विल सी द नेक्स्ट टाइप विच इज कार्ल पियर्सन्स कोरिलेशन कोएफिशिएंट। बिफोर दैट वी हैव सीन हाउ टू ड्रॉ द स्कैटर डायग्राम्स टू फाइंड आउट द टाइप ऑफ कोरिलेशन, दैट इज वेदर देयर इज अ पॉजिटिव और निगेटिव कोरिलेशन और देयर इज नो कोरिलेशन बिटवीन द टू वेरिएबल्स। Now we will see the Carl Pearson's correlation coefficient. To overcome the demerits of scatter diagram, we use this Carl Pearson coefficient, and it is given by R equals to covariance between xy divided by sigma x into sigma y, where sigma x and sigma y are the standard deviation of x and y, and covariance is defined as 1 upon n into summation of xi minus x bar into yi minus y bar. So this is the formula for covariance which we have already studied. Then we can put all the formulas in R. We get R equals to, this is the formula for covariance, upon 1 upon n summation of xi minus x bar bracket square into 1 upon n summation of yi minus y bar bracket square. So standard deviation is the square root of variance. So we can write this. Further, we have simplified this formulae. So 1 upon n summation of xi yi minus x bar y bar. This is simplified formula for covariance, and root of 1 upon n into summation of xi square minus x bar square into root of 1 upon n summation yi square minus y bar square. So instead of using this formula, we can use this simplified formula. So if we are given the observations or a data on x and y, the two variables, then only making the columns x, y, then x square, y square and xy. So only making these columns and taking the summations and substituting in this formula, we will find out the correlation between x and y. Now let us see some properties of Carl Pearson's correlation coefficient. The first property is correlation between x minus a upon h and y minus b upon k. So let us find out the effect of change of origin and scale on correlation. So it is actually correlation of x and y. So this means that it is not affected by effect of change of origin and scale. Let us see its proof. For that, suppose that u equal to x minus a upon h and v equal to y minus b upon k. So from property of arithmetic mean, we know that u bar is x bar minus a upon h and v bar is y bar minus b upon k. So let us write down the definition of correlation. So correlation between u and v is defined as covariance between u and v upon sigma u into sigma v. Let us find out step by step. So covariance between u and v, so we have previously obtained this in the properties of covariance in the last video. So 1 upon n summation of ui minus u bar into vi minus v bar. So let us put all the values of ui and vi, ui, u bar, vi and v bar. We have xi minus a upon h minus x bar minus a upon h into yi minus b upon k minus y bar minus b upon k. So by solving this we have 1 upon hk into covariance between x comma y. This is the property of covariance. Now let us obtain this sigma u and sigma v. So sigma u, so by definition it is given by root of 1 upon n into summation of ui minus u bar bracket square. So this is the property of variance. So effect of change of origin and scale on variance. So let us see it again. It will be 1 upon n summation of xi minus a upon h minus x bar minus a upon h bracket square. So by solving this we have 1 upon h, so sigma x upon mod of h. Similarly we can write sigma v. So sigma v will be sigma y upon modulus of k. In the similar manner we can prove it. Let us substitute all these values in this formula. So we have 1 upon hk into covariance of xy divided by 1 upon modulus of h into k into sigma x sigma y. So here we can observe that this constant will get cancelled if they have absolute equal sign of algebraic sign, then we have this is equal to r, which is correlation between x and y. So here we have proved that correlation between u and v is the same as correlation between x and y, that is if the constant h and k have equal algebraic sign. In case when they have opposite algebraic sign, then we have to write correlation between u and v will be minus of correlation between x and y. Note that this is the case when h and k have opposite algebraic signs. We can write correlation between ax plus b comma cy plus d as equal to correlation between x and y, because just now we have proved that correlation is not affected by change of origin and change of scale. If a and c have equal algebraic sign, then we can write this. If they have opposite algebraic sign, then suppose correlation of minus x comma y, so this should be written as minus of correlation between x and y. Similarly, if correlation between x comma minus y, then it should be written as minus of correlation between x and y. So these are the particular cases of this property. Now we will see the next property of Carl-Pearson correlation coefficient. The second property is r always lies between minus 1 and 1. So this is the range of r. Let us prove this property by two methods. The first method is we have to consider this is the correlation between x and y, which is denoted by r. X and y are the two variable. Then xi minus x bar upon sigma x minus yi minus y bar upon sigma y. If we take its bracket square, then it must be positive. We know that if we take the square of any term, then it is always greater than 0. So we consider this term now. Let us solve this bracket square. Before that, multiply it by 1 upon n and take a summation. So let us solve this bracket square now. It will be 1 upon n into summation of xi minus x bar upon sigma x square माइनस ट्वाइस एक्स आई माइनस एक्स बार अपॉन सिग्मा एक्स इंटू वाई आई माइनस वाई बार अपॉन सिग्मा वाई एंड प्लस वाई आई माइनस वाई बार अपॉन सिग्मा वाई ब्रैकेट स्क्वेयर. दिस मस्ट बी ग्रेटर देन जीरो. लेट अस टेक दिस वन समेशन साइन इन साइड द ब्रैकेट. एट द सेम टाइम वी विल मल्टीप्लाई बाय वन अपॉन एन. सो वी हैव वन अपॉन एन हियर. वन अपॉन सिग्मा एक्स स्क्वेयर विल बी कॉन्स्टेंट फॉर फर्स्ट टर्म. सो वन अपॉन एन समेशन ऑफ एक्स आई माइनस एक्स बार ब्रैकेट स्क्वेयर देन माइनस दिस टू इज अ कॉन्स्टेंट ऑल्सो sigma x and sigma y can be written here and 1 upon n into summation of xi minus x bar into yi minus y bar plus here also 1 upon sigma y square is a constant again 1 upon n summation of yi minus y bar bracket square. This whole term must be positive. Further we know from the definition of variance, this is the formula for variance. So we can write sigma x square upon sigma x square minus 2 times. This is the covariance term. So 2 times covariance between xy upon sigma x sigma y. And further sigma y square upon sigma y square. This whole term is positive. Let us solve this further. It will be 1 minus 2r plus 1 is positive. So we have written r. So this is the formula for correlation. Then 2 minus 2r is greater than 0. So 2 is greater than or equal to 2r means r must be less or equal to 1, or we can write like this. So r, the maximum value of r will be 1. Now let us consider the similar term. So here I am changing it. So if we take addition of these two constants, then its square must be positive. We know that if we take any term and take its square, then it is positive. So here, before we have used the subtraction sign, now we are taking the addition sign. And similar changes will be there. So while solving this, we have to write like this. So plus, and here also plus. Then here will be plus. Now, here we have to write 2 plus 2r means 2 is greater than or equal to 2r. So here will be 2r is greater than or equal to minus 2. Now this 2 will get cancelled and r is greater than or equal to minus 1. So minimum value of r is minus 1. So from these two, that maximum value is a 1 and minimum value is minus 1, we should write this r should lies between minus 1 and 1. So Carl Pearson's correlation coefficient, its range is from minus 1 to plus 1. Now this proof can be taken by alternative method, which is Cauchy-Schwarz inequality. So by using this inequality, we can prove that the Carl Pearson correlation coefficient will lie between minus 1 and 1. We know this inequality as summation of ai bi bracket square is always less than or equal to summation of ai square into summation of bi square. So let us put this ai as xi minus x bar and this bi as yi minus y bar. So by substituting this value in Cauchy-Schwarz inequality, we have xi minus x bar into yi minus y bar bracket square will be less or equal to summation of xi minus x bar bracket square into summation of yi minus y bar ब्रैकेट स्क्वायर. नाउ लेट अस डिवाइड बोथ साइड विथ एन स्क्वायर. सो वी हैव वी कैन राइट हियर एन एंड इट विल बी स्क्वायर्ड हियर. नाउ आई कैन राइट हियर एन एंड वन एन हियर. नाउ वी कैन ऑब्जर्व दैट दिस इज द formula for covariance between x y, its bracket square is less or equal to sigma x square into sigma y square. These are the formula of variance. Now if we take this to this side, we have this as r, so r square is less or equal to 1. Since it is a square, this implies that r lies between minus 1 and 1. So this is the alternative method by which we can prove this property of correlation coefficient, that it lies between minus 1 and 1. Now let us see the interpretations of the values of r. If this r is greater than 0, means if it is positive, then we say that there is a positive correlation between x and y. If this r is negative, so it lies between minus 1 to 0, then we say that there is negative correlation between x and y. Further, if this r is equals to 0, then we say that there is no correlation between x and y. Similarly, if r is having its maximum value, so if r equals to 1, then there must be perfect positive correlation. Means we have learned about the scatter diagram and it looked like this for perfect positive correlation. And finally, if r is equals to minus 1, then there must be perfect negative correlation. And the scatter diagram look like this. So these are some interpretations of r. If this r value is equal to 0.3 or less than 0.3, then the correlation is negligible. But if the value of r is greater than 0.8, then there must be relation between x and y, which is not negligible. So in this way we can interpret this r. Now let us see the next concept, which is variance of linear combination. So if this is a linear combination between x and y, a and b are any constants and x and y are the variables. So we can compute its variance. So this is the variance of linear combination. So variance of u will be variance of ax plus by. And we can obtain this. So this will be, by definition, it is 1 upon n summation of ui minus u bar bracket square. Further, it will be 1 upon n summation of ui is ax plus by, and this u bar will be ax bar minus this is by bar bracket square. Again, if we take this as a common, we have summation of a into xi minus x bar minus this will be, if we take b constant, so b into y minus y bar, we have to write plus and bracket square. Further, we can solve this bracket square. 1 upon n summation of a square into xi minus x bar bracket square. I will multiply this 1 upon n and summation to each. So 2 times this is AB summation of xi minus x bar yi minus y bar upon n, and finally plus b square into summation of yi minus y bar bracket square. So further we can write this has 1 upon n into this will be a square into sigma x square plus twice ab into covariance between x y and plus b square into sigma y square. So this is the variance of u. So in this way we can write or simplify. Further we know that this covariance term can be written as 2 times ab, this is r into sigma x into sigma y, this b square sigma y square. So by substituting the different values of a and b, we are able to obtain the linear variance of linear combination of x and y. So suppose a is equal to 1 and b is equal to 1, we can obtain variance of x plus y. Or if a equal to 1, b equal to minus 1, we can obtain variance of x minus y by using this formula. So by putting any values of a and b which are constants, we are able to obtain the variance of linear combination between x and y. Let us see some results. Suppose x, y and z are uncorrelated variables having same standard deviation sigma. So this is a given information. Then we can obtain this correlation between x plus y and y plus z. So let us obtain it. So by definition, it will be covariance between x plus y and y plus z upon this is a root or a sigma of x plus y and sigma of y plus z. Let us denote it by u and v. So we have u equal to x plus y and v equal to y plus z. Now we will obtain covariance between u v first. So we have covariance between x plus y and y plus z. This can be written as covariance between x comma y plus covariance between x comma z plus covariance between y and finally covariance between yz. So since we are given that x, y, z are uncorrelated variables, so these covariances must be zero and only the term covariance between y and y, this will be equal to sigma square. Again we will solve sigma of u. So sigma of u can be written as it is the standard deviation between x plus y. So if we solve this, we have, let us solve for variance. So variance of x plus y will be sigma x square plus sigma y square and plus 2 time covariance of x and y. This we have written from the previous. So it will be again covariance term between x and y is 0 and sigma, this can be written as sigma square plus sigma square, which is 2 sigma square. And if we want its standard deviation, then standard deviation or a sigma u can be square root, so 2 times sigma square. Similarly, we can prove sigma v equal to root of 2 sigma square. In the similar manner, we can prove this. Now let us substitute all these values in the formula of correlation. So correlation between u and v, so it will be 2 sigma square divided by, this is root of 2 sigma square into root of 2 sigma square, and which is equal to half. So we have the covariance between u and v as half. So today we have learned the Karl-Pearson's correlation coefficient, its properties and some examples. There are some merits and demerits of Karl-Pearson's correlation coefficients. The merits are it summarizes the data or given observations into a single numeric value. So this is the merit of Karl-Pearson correlation coefficient. Also it is depending on all observations. There are some demerits also. So it cannot be calculated for qualitative data since we require the numeric values to calculate it. So it is not calculated for the qualitative data. Also, if there is a non-linear relationship between x and y like this, suppose x and y are given to be, this is minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1 and 2, and y are suppose this, then we can observe that there is non-linear relationship between x and y, we know it. But if we calculate its correlation, then here summation x will be equal to 0 and summation of xy will be equal to 0. This implies that covariance term equal between x and y is 0, and which implies that r equal to 0. So it says that there is no correlation between x and y. But we can observe that there is a relation which is non-linear between x and y. So this is the demerit of Karl-Pearson correlation coefficient. And to overcome these demerits, we use the next type of correlation, which is rank correlation coefficient, which we will study in next video. So thanks for watching.